So it's time for Blue to get her fluids in to be fed. And Bonnie, I'm going to give her your shirt. We're going to see how she reacts to that. I should close the tub because she has jumped in there on occasion. I know. I know, Blue. I know. It's okay. Look. It's your mommy's shirt. We're not even happy with mommy's shirt, are we? She knows that the tube is on her right side and that I need to get to the tube. So she pushes that up against the side of the carrier. So if I can cover her face, it's harder for her to get me. Not that she will not try. It's okay, Blue. It's okay, Blue. Come on. Come on. I need you to turn. Good girl, Blue. Good girl, Blue. Turn your head a little. It's okay, Blue. I know. I well understand how angry you are with me. You've made that abundantly clear. I think there's actually a purple needle on the counter. Oh, no, right there on top. Perfect. Either one. There you go. So first I'm going to try and give her her fluids, the operative word being try. So I can feel her collars here, and what I need to do is get her neck behind her collar where I can hold her securely, hopefully not out getting hurt. Okay, Blue. I hear you, Mommy. I hear you. You are feeling better. But you're not out of the woods, so in spite of you thinking you're done with me, I'm not done with you. So we tent the skin, make a flat surface and pull it taut, and then push the skin onto the needle, and then you make sure that the skin isn't caught, like you didn't go through like you're sewing a seam. And turn it on, and I can see the line. It's flowing very well. Okay. Okay, Blue. So we're going for 100 to 150 cc's. I know, Blue. This is her famotidine. It's the generic name for Pepcid, and it is available in an injectable form, which is much easier than getting something into her mouth. Although I could crush it and put it through her feeding tube. Since it's available and since I can just put it in the port, it does not sting. So it's no more aggravation than the fact she's already getting fluids. Okay, there you go. There you go. I know. All this extra fluid helps flush out those excess liver enzymes, okay, Blue? I know. I hear you. I hear you, baby Blue. Fluid lump there. So this is her Sirenia. It's also clear, but it's a different volume. This stings if you put it in directly. So what you want to do is find the fluid pouch, so where the fluid is gathering under the skin, and inject it in there, and you hope that you're really in the fluid pouch. I must have been, because she didn't scream. I know. So this is her mixture of prescription AD and prescription rebound, I think it's called, the recuperation fluid. She is starting to eat a little bit on her own. Yesterday I gave her the appetite stimulant, but she's definitely not eating enough to clear the liver enzymes. Okay, I need to get to your tube, which is over there, which is going to make you very angry at me again. I know, I don't want to torture you. That's just the way it works sometimes, Blue. That's just the way it works sometimes, Blue. I know, I know. Now, I wanted to find my hemostat, but I don't see it. Because I've been trying to, it's a big metal clip. Maybe it's on the counter in there, not being very organized. Hi. Okay, all I want is that tube. I want that tube. Do you see it?
No.
No. If I can get that tube. Okay. Okay, Blue. You're okay. You're okay. So, getting the cap off. Here's the rule, Blue. Don't slap or bite Cindy, okay? You're a good girl. You're a good girl, Blue. I don't know if you can see, but this catheter tip syringe fits into the tube. And we've increased her from 15 cc's to 17 to 18. See, Blue? Very vociferously, she makes the food bubble back up the tube. Because the growls seem to come from down below. Okay, a little bit of water so your tube doesn't get clogged up. Okay. Camera over. Blue? Hi.